and the House of Wax has given way to some huge underground cavern. Strangely enough, those two small platforms over there are going to fall when you jump on them, so you want to make sure you kill that bat before you start jumping on them, because otherwise he will severely mess up your vacation plans. As in, you will die instead of going on vacation this year. And you know, that can put a damper on anyone's vacation. I almost said hamper. It will not put a hamper on your vacation, because a hamper is a thing that you keep clothes in. Me speak English good. Damn it. And this is the level where the furniture starts randomly attacking us. And there are daggers flying around the house, making it a house of flying daggers. Oh-ho! That was a good shot. That was an epic shot. I'm building up a nice little collection of bombs here. There's a one-up coming up here that's a little bit tricky. If you fall straight down after collecting it, you will die. So what you want to do is hold to the left. Because really, there's nothing more embarrassing than dying trying to get a one-up. It's like adding insult to injury. Damn it. The daggers are small, annoying, hard to hit, and they hurt. They're as bad as the animals. And of course we have chairs and candle holders and portraits of John F. Kennedy flying at us too. Kind of bogus that they just have a portrait of some random guy. It would have been nice if it was a picture of, oh, I don't know, say Dracula. I mean, at this point in the game, there's really almost no indication that this game has anything to do with Dracula. Except for, you know, the box art, where you're clearly defeating Dracula in an epic battle. But I mean, so far we've dealt with Jack the Ripper, and we've dealt with some weird dude. Well, we haven't dealt with a weird dude yet, but we're about to. We're on stage 3, which means we're going to fight a boss. I do not want that axe. I'm very happy with my cane, thank you. I'm going to give you such a caning. Okay, this part of the game is a little unfair. If you jump and you try to get that second power up, the one all the way over to the right, you're probably going to fall in that crack between the houses and die. Which really isn't very nice of them. But what are you going to do? That's poker for you. Gotta know when to hold them and when to fold them. Wait, that's not applicable. Never mind. A delicious potion of vitality. Man, I have a lot of grenades. I'm a grenade-toting fool. Ow. Getting pretty close to the boss, I suspect. I don't know what's in the mass to the left. I'm a little... Oh, just a one-up. Good. Yeah, in case you haven't noticed, it really wants you to have enough health in this game. This is like Castlevania for wusses, basically. But I'm okay with that. Whoa! Of course, that's only when you compare it to the original Castlevania. Blood. Blood. This chick's kind of creepy. Our arsenal of grenades will come in handy here. All we have to do is hit the skull until it dies. pretty nicely animated skull. Aw, man. It totally looks like she farted the skull out. That's horrible. It's horrible that I thought of that. I'm sure I'm the only person who would look at that and think something like that. That's what the animation looked like, though. I can't help it. I didn't program the game. Aw, poor girl. All she did was throw flying skulls at us and beg for our young, fresh blood. Yeah. Oh, more story. Goody. Oh, that was the psychic girl. Apparently she was throwing psychic skulls at us. Dark forces. Wonder what those forces could be. There was no way to know what the message was warning him about. Well, gee, I don't know. Maybe it was warning me about the cemetery east of town? Like, maybe I shouldn't go to the cemetery? But of course, that's exactly where I go. This guy doesn't listen to warnings very well. Whoa. This place is going to be zombie headquarters. Damn it. Yeah, the music for this part's not really very good. But, oh well. Beggars can't be choosy. I don't want a gun. I have 23 grenades. Why would I get a gun? Now I have 31 grenades. It's too bad, though, because 23 is such a great number. It has all sorts of mythical, occult connotations. Or not occult, but just like, you know. It's popular among the tinfoil hat conspiracy types. I don't know why. In fact, I'm not even sure if that's true or not. I read it on the internet, but that might have been somebody joking around. 23 skidoo! That's old American for... Get the fuck out of here. I think. My old American isn't very fluent. Whoa. I can break this wall open. Do I want to do that, or do I want to go over on the left-hand side? Oh, damn it. Well, we'll say I don't have a choice now. I got the axe, therefore I have to go down. Whoa! That's a nasty trap. In case you're wondering, getting the axe had nothing to do with my decision. It was just a convenient scapegoat. Hey, more grenades. Too bad I have to impale myself to get them. That looks like a breakable wall. No? That's surprising. Oh yeah, I think I can just jump up there. I don't know what that was. One up, perhaps? I have 6 of them now, so it looks like that might be the case. Damn it! Alright, I'll go this way. Epic slowdown. Gun, no thanks. Like I said, who needs a gun when you have 38 grenades? Now this is a breakable wall. And that would be the end of Stage 1 of the cemetery, or whatever this is. So I will see you next time on Let's Play Master of Darkness. I'm Duke of the Bomb.